Till then, we have some time to let people know about this lesson and to invite some of our other brothers and sisters to gain more knowledge about Islam. May Allah help us spread His message and the message of His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam to entire humanity, that we may find peace and tranquility and blessings of Allah, and that He would admit us all into His paradise inshallah. We are reaching to Ramadan, and generally speaking, Ramadan is an amnesty that Allah is declaring for all of His humanity, for non-Muslims to know about, to learn about Islam and come to the right path of Allah, the path that the Creator wanted His creatures, mankind and jinnkind and everyone to follow. It's Him who created the world, so He set the rules. And it's an amnesty for all Muslims who had been sinning away from Allah and not being even careful of doing their obligatory things like prayer and fasting and things related to our akhlaq, to our behavior and our transactions and all that should be in accordance with Allah's laws. And people who had been heedless in these things, maybe out of ignorance, maybe they didn't know about it, maybe they're just heedless, careless. Allah is declaring His amnesty. So any country, even in UAE, we had a time that declared amnesty, public amnesty, that they could be easily, you know, they need to be surrendering, yeah? And they will be forgiven. No fines. Allah is declaring that Ramadan is coming to you. It's a time that I'm oft forgiving. I will be forgiving all your sins. That like in amnesty, you have to surrender. You have to come in complete humility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and surrender yourselves. Submit yourselves to Allah. I'm guilty. Forgive me. If you do that, Allah is ready to forgive you. It's a time to purify ourselves. The generations before us had been given a long lifespan, like Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, as mentioned in the Holy Quran. He lived more than 1,000 years. In some of the tafsir, it came more than 1,300 years time. He spent almost 950 years inviting people to Islam. So you can imagine there will be some time before he became a prophet and the time after he concluded his message. Such a long lifespan. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a bit upset, knowing that أَعْمَارُ أُمَّتِي مَا بَيْنَ سِتِّينَ وَسَبْعِينَ, that the lifespan of the people who coming after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is going to be between 70 and 60. There's a very few people who survive beyond 80 and 90s, and if they reach 100, it's going to be big news in the newspaper. Somebody's turned 100, 110, it's a big news. So we have been given a very short time. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam explaining to his companions that someone in the early communities, he fought in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 1,000 years, and the companions got upset. Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself got upset, because my people won't be able to do all these things because they've been given a lifespan very short, 60 and 70, what can they do? The people before us did lots of good deeds, so they might be given a high rank in Jannah, and my people will be in the lower level. So he was really upset on behalf of us. It was then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the famous surah, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. Don't be upset, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I'm here to compensate you something better than living many years and to suffer in here. So you live a shorter life, but you get a lot many things. Subhanallah. Allah revealed, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Inna الله في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر. Definitely we have sent down Quran in the night of power, ليلة القدر. وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر. O Messenger of Allah, what do you know about ليلة القدر? What it is? ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. It's a night better than 1,000 months, and 1,000 months is equal to 83 years. A night better than 83 years. خير من ألف شهر. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها. And in that night, they will ascend. All of the mighty angels of Allah, along with their leader, Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, who is termed as Ruh. Ruh also means soul, but here it refers to Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, the leader of the angels. And he will come down. Salamun hiya. The night, the whole night is peace. Hatta matla'il fajr. Until the dawn, it will be peace. And if anything you do, that will be worth doing 83 years in your life. So that is better. If someone living 60 years of time, and all the actions that count after someone reach its maturity or puberty. So after 15 years of age, you can take 45 years. Somebody living 60, you'll be getting 45 years. 45 years of Ramadan. 45 Ramadan, and each Ramadan he meets with Laylatul Qadr. He spends some time in front of Allah, spending the whole night, which is equal to 83 years of time. So you multiply 83 by 45. If somebody is living 60 years of time, subhanAllah, how many years he had lived? Not literally, but in regards of the rewards you're going to get. So that is amazing. And Allah put it in the night of Ramadan. These five nights, one of the odd nights after 20th of Ramadan. 21, 23, 25, 27 and 29th. It could be any of these nights. And you can win 83 years in your life. Subhanallah. The chance is in five. Right, we do fill up some coupons, right? when you see there's a box, oh, somebody gonna win 1,000,000 dirhams. If you just fill it down, you drop it in, and you wait for how many people are there writing in there, you know, drawing themselves to this, putting themselves this in the draw. There will be hundreds of thousands of people, yeah. And when they take one or two or three in, the chance that your name come under these is very, very, very low probability. It's very low. You're one among a million people. Still, we spend some time filling in these coupons, yeah? In shopping malls, stand up now, summer sales and stuff. Subhanallah. And Allah says, five nights. In any of these five, it's definitely sure. It can be 21, it can be 23, it can be 25, it can be 27. But normally after 27, we're going to stop. Oh, Ramadan is over. Now you're going to end up in streets, yeah? But it can be 29. Five nights. And you can add 83 years to your life. This is Allah's amnesty. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all his companions and the Muslims who passed before us were very eager to get Ramadan. They used to pray, Allahumma sallimna ila Ramadan, wa sallim Ramadan lana, wa tasallamhu minna mutaqabbala. Oh Allah, make us safe, that we safely meet Ramadan, and make Ramadan safe for us. And Allah, once Ramadan is over, you may please accept it from us. They used to pray, when Rajab comes, the month, holy month of Rajab comes, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to pray, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajabin wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, bless us in Rajab and Sha'ban, and we are in the last few days of Sha'ban. وَبَلِّغْنَا Ramadan, and let Ramadan reach us. Bring Ramadan to us. وَفِقْنَا فِيهِ لِلسُّيَامِ وَالْقِيَامِ, and may Allah, you may bless us to do more of praying and fasting and recitation of Quran. They used to pray. They used to go out and watch for the new moon of Ramadan. The early people, Islamic, our ancestors, they used to pray to Allah to bring Ramadan for 6 months. Before Ramadan, 6 months they will be praying, oh Allah, make me alive until I reach the next Ramadan. And after the Ramadan is over, the next 6 months they will ask Allah, you may please accept all those things that we have done in Ramadan for you. Our prayers, our Taraweeh, our Quran, our charity. Accept us from us. How long? Not one day. Not for 1 week. 6 months they will ask Allah to accept it. And the next 6 months they will ask Allah to bring Ramadan to them. So they were such, but why? Why did they do so? Because it's a month of blessings. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when it was time for the last few days of Sha'ban, he stood among them and he gave a speech in sermon. In that he mentioned, "Atakum shahru Ramadan." Ramadan has come to you. You know, it was yet to come. Shahru barakah is a month of blessings. What do you mean by blessings? What is blessings? Blessings is that you get something more what you expected from. You have 10 dirhams, but you have done something that could be done only by 100 dirhams. But you only spend 10 and all your needs were met. That is a blessing. You got only a short period of time and you did lots of things. That wasn't possible in that short period of time. But you could do a lot many other things. SubhanAllah, there's a blessings. You have a little food, you eat it and you're full and you're satisfied. But normally it takes you to eat a few plates, but now you're, mashallah, you just ate a little and you're okay. It's a blessing. SubhanAllah. Ramadan, Allah will send down His blessings, barakah. And barakah means, is nothing to compensate you. There's reward and there is blessings. The reward is for what you do, you get the reward, you get the wages, you get what you deserve at the end of the month, yeah? We get the salary paid because you deserve that. That's what you did for the company, so you deserve something in return. But when it comes for barakah, Allah may not need anything from you. Allah can give you instantly looking at the purity of your hearts. SubhanAllah. Shahrul barakah. فِيهِ خَيْرٌ يُغْشِيكُمُ اللَّهُ, and Allah will cover you with khair, with lots of virtues. فَيُنْزِلُ الرَّحْمَةِ, and Allah will send down His mercy on you. وَيَحَتُّ فِيهِ الْخَطَايَا, and Allah will wipe out all your sins. وَيَسْتَجِيبُ فِيهِ الدُّعَاءَ, and Allah will accept your supplications. يَنْظُرُ اللَّهُ إِلَى تَنَافُسِكُمْ وَيُبَاهِي بِكُمْ مَلَائِكَتَهُ, Allah will be looking at your competitions, how you challenge each other. Somebody as your friend going to recite one juz of Quran. No, I'm going to read two juz. Your friend says, I'm going to pray tonight, I will stand up in prayer. I will be praying 10 rak'ahs after I sleep, I will wake up. Then you're going to make, no, I'm going to make it 20 rak'ahs. Your competitions. Somebody is spending 100 dirhams and you say, no, I'm going to spend it 200. فَيُبَاهِي بِكُمْ مَلَائِكَةً, and Allah will be proud, pointing towards you. Allah will tell, look at my angels, you look at them. How wonderfully they're using this time, because the angels once, before the creation of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, what did they say to Allah? Allah had a discourse with them, yeah? Allah asked, Ya Malaika, oh my angels, inni ja'ilun fil ardi khalifa. I'm going to appoint my representative onto the earth. I'm going to create Adam. I'm going to create humans on the earth. What did the angels say? They said, okay, ya Allah, that's fine. It's a good decision. Did they say that? What did they say? Ataj'alu fiha man yufsidu fiha أتجعل فيها من يفسد فيها ويسفك الدماء نحن نسبح بحمدك ونقدس لك قال إني أعلم ما لا تعلمون. Oh Allah, why should you create humans who would fight each other, who would shed blood? They knew what is going to happen, subhanallah. There used to be some jinns living in the earth before our humans were created. They knew what the jinns did. They fought each other. So Allah, why should you make someone who will be fighting each other? And yet we are here to glorify you, to give, to praise you, to glorify you, to do tasbih, to do Allahu Akbar, to worship for you. We are here. Why should you create somebody else? What did Allah reply? إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُ. Definitely I know what you don't know. So Allah said, oh angels, you told me what the humans are going to do on the earth. They're going to do horrible things. And look at them, how when the Ramadan came, mashallah, they're all competing each other in the good things. So I'm proud of them. Look at them. This is the month that Allah will be proud of you when you compete in doing good things. فَأَرُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ خَيْرًا. So show Allah goodness out of you. Show Allah good things. The time you are spending in front of the TVs, you know, that's not going to be end anyway. You can't finish watching all the movies out there. Even if you've given double of your lifetime, you won't be able to finish. You won't be able to finish, you know, watching all these serials and all this, you know, listening to the comedians. You can't finish your life even reading all the books. You choose what is worth reading. There are many things out there where you can waste your time. So don't waste your time. Show Allah goodness out of you. Ramadan has come. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was mentioning, subhanallah. And what he mentions, if you do something that is obligatory, that is a fariḍah, that is a compulsory action, if you do that, so if you do a sunnah, which is an optional, a supererogatory action, which is a sunnah, an optional thing, Allah will give you the reward of a compulsory thing. Because you know, in Islam, more reward is given for the compulsory things. We have five times prayer, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha and Fajr, yeah? And we have sunnah prayers. Rasulullah ﷺ used to mention, whoever prays for Allah, 12 rak'at. I'm going to mention it inshallah during our talk. So sunnah prayers are there, before and after. Logically thinking, what should be given more reward? For the sunnah or for the compulsory thing? For the compulsory thing or for the sunnah? What we think? Logically speaking, right? I told you something to bring in, but you brought something else. So, would you be praised for bringing something more or just bringing that? Definitely something more, right? But with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is giving you more rewards for the compulsory actions. Subhanallah. It is, you should be doing that. You're bound to do that. But yet Allah gives you more rewards. But in Ramadan, if you do a sunnah action, Allah will give you a reward of a fard, a compulsory action. And normally Allah will give every good deed 10 times. 10 times reward. But during Ramadan, it could be 70, 700, 7,000 and even more. يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَسَى. Looking at the sincerity in your heart, Allah will give you the rewards in manifolds. Allah knows. Allah knows how sincere your heart is. So Ramadan is a time, I can't say it's a bumper prize, it's amazing. Endless prizes. Yet people don't use it. People do all the things that they used to do before Ramadan, just continue. You know, apart from the fact that they just starve a few hours of the morning, you know what they do? They just starve. They starve and they sleep. They eat quite a lot when they break their fasting. Yeah, and at the time of dawn they eat quite a lot, and from Fajr to Dhuhr they're sleeping, and they pray Dhuhr if they pray, and again sleep, then they get up for Asr, and again sleep, then they wake up for Iftar, and they break the fast. Is this fasting? Is this the fasting that Allah meant for you? No. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَجْرِي مِنْ إِبْنِ آدَمَ مَجْرَ الدَّمِ فَضَيِّقُوا مَجَارِيهِ بِالْجُوعِ. We mentioned this surah, this hadith, when we were talking about Surah An-Nas, about the whispering of shaitan. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions what? Shaitan is moving around your body wherever blood circulation is there. Wherever blood is passing, shaitan is moving all over there into your entire body. فَضَيِّقُوا مَجَارِيهِ بِالْجُوعِ. So you have to make his pathways narrow, make it very narrow for him. He shouldn't be passing that quickly. What should he do? بِالْجُوعِ, suffer hunger. Suffer hunger, taste the hunger. And that's not only the purpose of fasting. We may think, fasting is meant to be that we suffer only hunger. It's not. People say, oh, Allah made fasting obligatory upon us just to think upon, poor people out there who can't eat. So you suffer and you think of them, so you give charity. It can be one of the meaning, but that's not the purpose of fasting. What did Allah mention about the purpose of fasting? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. All those who believe. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ. You have to be fasting. Fasting has been made obligatory upon you, compulsory upon you. كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. Don't worry, even people before you have been given fasting obligatory. They did fasting. Why? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. That you should be more mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How? You could eat and drink during the other days of Ramadan, the other times you can eat and drink, all the halal stuffs. Innumerous, endless halals. Haram things are few. You can eat all the halal, but when you're fasting, you're not taking even the halal. A cup of water, you can drink any time if you're not fasting. But when you're fasting for Allah, you don't drink. There is food out there in the kitchen, you don't go there. There are some shops, some outlets out there, they have some food to serve you, but you don't go and eat. Why? It is halal for you and yet you abstain from it because you are fasting. So this is a training for you, that you abstain from all the haram things. If you can abstain from the halal, that should be make you even stronger to abstain and restrain from the haram things out there. Subhanallah. If you can keep away from halal, you can keep away yourself out of haram very easily. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. This is the purpose of fasting. So you should suffer hunger. Imam al-Ghazali radiallahu anhu mentioning about the virtues of fasting, he mentioned, if a person eating too much when he breaks his fast, he can't do his prayers properly. He'll be lazy for his Isha prayer. He'll be extremely tired when praying, standing up for Taraweeh, and he can make any of his night prayers. And if somebody is eating too much at the time of Sahri, we say Suhoor, the meal at the early dawn, he can't do anything until Dhuhr. He will be just sleeping and sleeping and sleeping. So don't waste your time. Subhanallah. Ramadan, the entire time of Ramadan, if you take the holy month of Ramadan, you've been given 720 hours. Ramadan is, is 720 hours. That is the entire Ramadan. Subhanallah. And if you sleep 8 hours a day, that's not good, that you sleep that much during Ramadan, then it comes around 470 hours. So you're talking about utilizing your 470 hours during the month of Ramadan. Subhanallah. I'm going to give you some program, how we're going to benefit this Ramadan, inshallah. We're not going to talk too much because it's only 20, 25 minutes left. So I'm afraid we won't be able to finish. This time, this Ramadan, inshallah, we should be spending more time in asking Allah forgiveness. He's ready to forgive you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions when the Ramadan comes, in the first night of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in His might and glory, He will come down to the first sky. It doesn't mean He literally comes down. We learn about it when we were talking about Surah Qul Huwallahu Ahad. It doesn't mean physically He comes down, but yet by His mercy, by His compassion, by all His love, and He would say, who is out there asking me, and I'm ready to give them. Who is out there asking me their needs, I'm here to fulfill their needs. And every night and day of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ بِاللَّيْلِ يَتُوبَ مُسِيءُ النَّهَارِ. During night, Allah is spreading His hands. Doesn't mean literally, Allah doesn't have hands. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ. But Allah is spreading His mercy out there for you every night. Why? لِيَتُوبَ مُسِيءُ النَّهَارِ. Those who sinned, did crimes during daytime. We just finished today's day. Yeah, we are in the night of this day. So from the morning, from the time you woke up from your bed, until now, until Maghrib, we might have committed sins. We might have looked at something that is not worth looking. It's a sin to look at. We might have spent some time with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, didn't like you to do that. You might have spoken something. You might have sent some messages on your computer, on your social network, which you shouldn't be writing those words. Think of how many things since we have done until now, until the end of the day, and you didn't ask Allah forgiveness. Allah is asking you the whole night. Those who committed sins during daytime, are they ready to ask me forgiveness? I'm here to forgive them. Subhanallah. There are people who spend their nights in haram, listening to, watching, and spending time in haram things. They sleep. If they don't ask Allah forgiveness, what happens if they die in their sleep? What's going to be their fate at the end of their life? They spend the last thing. A man is considered upon what he did in his life lastly. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِخَوَاتِيمِهَا. Things are regarded as what you seal it with. You know, people, Allah will consider what is the last thing you did in your lifetime. This is how Allah is going to judge you upon. So think of, you did something wrong in the night and you spend your night without asking Allah forgiveness. And if Allah takes your soul and take him to him, and you're going to be buried in the grave, who is out there to help you? What would be your fate? Did you ask Allah forgiveness? But luckily, by the mercy of Allah, Allah again sends your soul back to you when you're asleep and you woke up. And you're walking in the daytime. Did you ask Allah forgiveness in the day for the sins you have done in the last night? Every day and night Allah is asking for you. The same continues during Ramadan. وَصُفِّدَتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put all the shaitans in chains. Allah is going to shackle them. They're not going to irritate you. They're not going to tempt you towards sins. But your body itself is inviting you to sin. Your body may long for something that Allah doesn't like. Are you going to listen to your own bodily passions, or you are listening to Allah's call? So when the shaitan, you may think that, oh, you mentioned shaitans are put in chains, but yet in Ramadan people do sins. You can see people walking in the streets. Same like as you were before, as they were before Ramadan, they continue to do all the haram things. So what is the point? Shaitans are blocked. They are shackled, put in chains. But yet, your own body is against you. Your own body is inviting you to the haram, to the hellfire. So are you going to listen to your own body? Or are you going to listen to the angelic calls, to Allah's call? Control yourself. Allah made everything easy for you. Subhanallah and mashaAllah. That's why during Ramadan you can see people who never, you know, did their prayers. You can see them, they start praying. But the sad part of it is that once Ramadan is over, they go back. They go back to their early life. So what is the point? The scholars of Islam mentioned, لا تكونوا رمضانيين وكونوا ربانيين. Don't be the slaves of Ramadan. Be the slaves of Rabb, Allah, your Lord. If you're just praying and listening to Allah during Ramadan and after Ramadan, you go all your past sins. You've been listening to Ramadan. And who is Ramadan? Ramadan is a sacred month. Why? Because Allah made it sacred. So don't be a slave of Ramadan. Be a slave of Allah. And Allah is out there after and before Ramadan. This is the point. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ It shouldn't be like a drama. People do some drama in Ramadan. And after Ramadan, they don't realize Allah is there. Subhanallah. So it's a time for repentance. For inner grief towards what we have did, towards all the sins that we have done, you know, towards Allah, without considering the status of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are two drops. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned two drops, and these won't never touch hellfire. قَطَرَةُ دَمٍ يُهْرَاقُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ is the bloodshed, is the drop of blood that's been shed in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those people who strive, you know, fighting and jihad for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like we had in the early centuries. Those drops are sacred. They won't go to the hellfire. وَقَطَرَةُ دَمْعٍ يُهْرَاقُ مِنْ وَقَطَعَةُ دَمْعٍ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ And a drop, an eye drop, and the drop of your eye. Subhanallah. An eye drop. مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ Out of the awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, if you take my soul and if you make me die and this time, what is going to be my fate? Forgive me, Allah. And Allah is oft forgiving. Allah can make you pure, like a newborn baby. No sins out there and your hearts are pure and shining. Allah can make it for you, provided you approach Allah sincerely in complete humility. Then Allah will give you knowledge. Then Allah will give you insight, some inner light, that you can see the life, how beautiful it is. And you can feel the happiness of this life. And you will be enjoying your praise and your submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once your heart is pure, that is the time. Ramadan is the time. Use it for purifications. And to increase into purifications, I'm going to give you some program. Number one, we spend more time with Quran. So we should be able to read it. So every time, every second we strive to read Quran, it's a blessing. Somebody didn't know how to read Arabic. You go to someone and read and learn to how to read Arabic. People are like, I can't do that. How come you say you can't do that? If you've been offered a job, a good job of a good salary, and they ask, oh, okay, we meet everything in you, but you need to do this course, and we can't give you an offer until you finish this course, this diploma. What do? You go for that, yeah? You search on internet, you ask everyone, oh, where can I do that? Subhanallah. So, if Allah can give you 10 rewards for reading a letter of Quran, one letter is 10 rewards. Why can't you read it? Why can't you learn Arabic then? So learn it. And during Ramadan you read every juz. If you allocate just half an hour during daytime, you have to prescribe what time you're going to do that. Don't make it in random timing. Half an hour during ray and half an hour during night. Or 25 minutes each. 1 hour in a day. Make it what time is convenient for you. To read one juz of Quran, you need 25 minutes. Half an hour. 35 minutes maximum if you're really slow. 20 pages is one juz. Read it in a daytime. Make a time for it. You make, as you make some schedules, you know, this half an hour I'm not going to do anything but reading Quran. Half an hour during night, if you read two juz, I'm giving you a good target. Two juz are you finishing every day? By the end of Ramadan, you would have completed Quran twice, two times. Subhanallah. And if you're really, really curious, subhanAllah, you can do even more. You can complete Quran even in 3 days. If you read before and after every prayer one juz, we have 5 prayers. If you read half, one juz before every prayer and one juz after, and you continue to do that, you'll be finishing Quran in 3 days during Ramadan. If you have high himma, high intention, go for that. Or at least finish it once. Or finish it 2 times. Because every juz contains 7,000 letters. We have Quran, 30 juz, isn't it? 30 parts are there. Every part containing 7,000 letters. Multiplied by 10. Is each letter? كُلُّ حَرَفٍ بِحَشْرِ حَسَنَاتٍ. Every letter will be given 10 hasanat. So if you read a juz that is 7,000 letters multiplied by 10, you'll be getting how many rewards? 70,000. SubhanAllah. Go for that. And we're going to do 30 umrah during Ramadan. How is that possible? The time for umrah has been reduced to 15 days, and how can you do 30 umrah in a Ramadan? Yeah, you can. Living in Abu Dhabi, not traveling to Mecca, you can do 30 umrahs during your Ramadan. How is that? You pray Salatul Fajr in the masjid. And after you pray Salatul Fajr, it's not good to pray any optional prayer, any sunnah mutlaq, until the sun rises. So you stay in the mosque until the sun rises, if it's possible for you. If you're going for work and there's no chance for that, you have an intention of Allah. Had I been able to do that, I would have done it. You will get the reward just for your intention. If you can make it, sit in the mosque until the sun rises. The sun rises up, and after 20 minutes the sun rises, the time for Salatul Ishraq or Salatul Duha. Some ulama, scholars say that Salatul Duha, the Duha prayer, and Salatul Ishraq both are the same or could be two different prayers. Anyway, this is optional. You can pray it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, if you pray Salatul Fajr in Jama'ah and you stay in the mosque until the sun rises, you know, up to the height of a spear, and that is considered 20 minutes after the sunrise, and you pray 2 rak'at sunnah in the mosque. 2 rak'at of sunnah, as simple as you can. It's as if you made a umrah. Umratin tammatin tamma. It's like a complete umrah. SubhanAllah. So you can do that 30 days of Ramadan, 30 umrahs. May Allah help us to do that. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. And use the mornings, morning times. Preferably if you're not tired, maybe if you had prayed the last night, you know, you stood up in praying, Qiyamul Layl, you know, you may need some rest, you can sleep, but you can spend the mornings in something good that is really important, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had a prayer. He did say that, Allahumma barik li ummati fi bukuriha. Oh Allah, give blessings for my people in whatever they do in the morning. So this is blessings. If you travel, make your journey right in the early morning. There is a blessing in that. If you have something to do, if possible, do it in the morning. Start your work in the morning. There is a blessing in there. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to send all the expeditions in those who go for jihad in his time. He used to send them in the early morning. Allahumma barik li ummati fi bukuriha. And the hadith is mentioned by a sahabi, Sakhr al-Ghamidi radiyallahu anhu. He was a merchant. He was a businessman. And he did all his business journeys in the morning. He's the one who narrated his hadith. And it's mentioned, since he did all his journeys in the morning, Allah blessed his business, and mashallah, he was amazingly rich because of using the early morning timing. So use it for something beneficial. Then you go for sleep, you need to take some rest. You have your duhr timing. And for thirdly, we have something to gain a palace in the Jannah. You will be given a palace in the Jannah. Subhanallah, you go to Jannah and you need Allah's blessings. Subhanallah. Have a high himmah, you know. We should have a high intentions, high objective. Don't make it low. People say, oh, my intention is just to be in Jannah. That would be too enough for me just to end there. I just want to be safe from the hellfire, from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's all right. But once you get there, you'll be upset looking at the other people, mashallah. Because Jannah is 100 levels. It's not like 100-story building. Each level between one to the other is a difference that of the, from the earth to the first sky. Mi'atu daraja. People come to work in the Gulf countries, you know, they say, I just need a visa, that's it. Once they come there and they look at this, oh, this is nothing what I'm getting compared to some. I needed at least 2,000 or 3,000 or 4,000. Yeah? I need to bring my families and I need, you know, 4,000 is not enough. You know, I need an 8,000 at least. Then it's, you live with your family. Oh, I could save nothing after my family is here. So I need at least 10, 15. Subhanallah, you're going to go for more and more. In Jannah, people will be, the only thing that can make people upset is looking at the people who are in the higher levels. Because once you are in the lower levels, you can't go and meet the people in the higher levels. Though the people in the higher levels can come down and see you, but you can't go up there. But you will be long, oh Allah, had I prayed, you know, this much of sunnah, I would be in that level. I didn't do that. You will be regretting when you get to the paradise. Subhanallah. That will be the only thing people will be upset about. Oh, I could do a lot many other things, but I spend my time doing this and that. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions that if you can pray, this is the hadith. Rahimallahu man salla. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions. من صلى لله اثنتي عشرة ركعة. Anyone praying for Allah 12 rak'ah of sunnah, بني له بهن بيت في الجنة. Allah will build for them a house, and that will be a mansion or a palace in the Jannah. How many rak'ah? 12 rak'ats. These are optional. Before and after you fard the prayer. Rak'atayn qabla al-fajr. 2 rak'ah before fajr, before the subh prayer, the morning prayer. 2 rak'ah before. 4 rak'ah before dhuhr and 2 rak'ah after dhuhr. And nothing before and after asr. 2 rak'ah after maghrib and 2 rak'ah after isha. How many are they now? 12. 2 before Fajr, can you recall that? 2 before Fajr, 4 before Dhuhr, 2 after Dhuhr. How many now? 8. Asr, nothing. For Maghrib, you pray 2 rak'ah after Maghrib. 10. 2 rak'ah after Isha. If you can pray these 12 Sunnah prayers, it shouldn't be only for Ramadan, you can keep it in your entire life. Allah will be giving you a palace every day. So think of how beautiful will be your world. I need to mention, Jannah, the paradise, is not a 3-bedroom flat. You know, Jannah is not. Allah's Jannah is not like, you shouldn't be imagining like it's a villa. It's not. The least rewarded in the paradise will be given twice of this world. The least rewarded in the paradise. The paradise is world. 2 times of this world is given for the lowest man, lowest people who have less good deeds. They're given twice of this world. Not that of Abu Dhabi. Not like that of UAE. Twice of this world. So you've been given Jannah and there is no place for you to live there. It's not going to be, you're not going to be appreciated, yeah? So, ask Allah, pray, you need to do some good deed. Pray 12 rak'ah sunnah. 2 rak'ah before Fajr, 4 rak'ah before Dhuhr, and you pray Dhuhr, and 2 after Dhuhr, 2 rak'ah after Maghrib, and 2 after Isha. There is sunnah before Asr, but it's not regarded in this hadith. Rasulullah mentioned, "Man salla qabla al-asr arba'an harramahu Allahu 'ala an-nar." If someone praying four rak'ah sunnah before asr, Allah will make, you know, nar, the hellfire, haram for him. You know, there's other blessings. But the hadith that mentions in Rasulullah guaranteeing for you paradise is the sunnah of this 12 rak'ah. So keep to do that. And keeping our night prayers, tarawih. من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever prays, stand up in prayer, in optional prayer during the nights of Ramadan, Allah will build for them, Allah will forgive all their past sins. But remember, only the minor sins. There are major sins that you should be asking Allah forgiveness. You should do tawbah, repentance for the major sins to be forgiven. But as far as the minor sins are concerned, they will be forgiven, you know, because of your tarawih prayer. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his companions, as is related from Sayyidina Umar al-Faruq radiyallahu anhu, they prayed 20 rak'at of tarawih. There are people who pray 8, there is a hadith for them. But it's really good that you can pray 20 rak'at, that's absolutely fine. Go for that. Stand up in prayer. And after you pray salatul tarawih, there is qiyamul layl, there is tahajjud. And tahajjud is the night prayers. You sleep, you can wake up 20 minutes before when the adhan goes on. Anyway, we will wake up for the morning meal, suhoor. Lots many people don't do that. They just eat their full and they sleep and they wake up for the fajr. Don't do that. تَسَحَّرُوا فَإِنَّ فِي السَّحُورِ بَرَكَةً. You should eat the sahri, you know, as it's called in Urdu, you know, sahri, suhoor, or sahur in Arabic. The meal before the adhan for fajr goes on, you know, eat sahar. Because the Jewish people, they don't eat, you know, sahar meal for their fasting. So we shouldn't be doing that. Rasulullah mentioned, tasaharu, eat the sahari. There is a blessing in fa'inna fi sahuri baraka. There is baraka in. At least you eat one date, a glass of water, some tea, and one bread, half bread, you know how. Subhanallah, there is a blessing in it. Don't lose that. And if you, anyway, you're waking up for the morning meal, so make your time 10 minutes before. You're not going to lose anything if you wake up 10 minutes before. Stand up in prayer. Pray 2 rak'ah of tahajjud, qiyam al-layl. Any prayer that you pray after you sleep during night is considered to be tahajjud. Any prayer that you pray, which is sunnah, after you sleep at night, that's considered to be tahajjud. So go for that, and as many you can. We have our great Imam, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal radiyallahu anhu, who used to pray 300 rak'at every day of sunnah. Subhanallah. He's the Imam for the Hanbali school of jurisprudence, Hanbali madhab. He used to pray 300 optional rak'at. Subhanallah. What we do? We pray all the 5 times prayer and we are really content. MashaAllah, I did my 5 times prayer. So our objective, our targets are too low. Make it high. Make it high. So that we don't regret when we get to the next world. You're preparing for the next world. Subhanallah. So, if you can't pray the night prayers, there is another option. Simply, if you're working overnight, for example, or you've been extremely tired and exhausted, you couldn't pray the night prayer, there is an option that Rasulullah ﷺ gives you. Easily you get blessings. What to do? مَنْ صَلَّى الْعِشَاءَ فِي زَمَاعَةٍ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَامَ نِصْفَ اللَّيْلِ. Whoever prays Isha prayer in jama'ah is as if he stood the half of the night in prayer. وَمَنْ صَلَّى الْفَجْرَ فِي جَمَاعَةٍ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَامَ نِصْفَ اللَّيْلِ. And whoever prays the morning prayer in jama'ah in the masjid is as if he prayed the half of the night. So you pray both Isha and Fajr in prayer in jama'ah, in congregation, in the mosque, in the masjid, is as if you pray the whole night in prayer. Subhanallah. So go for that. And it's applicable throughout the life, not necessarily for Ramadan, for your all your lifetime. May Allah help us to do all these things. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. There's not many hadiths. And there is 2 timings during Ramadan. Never miss it. two times that Allah will accept your prayers. That is only for Ramadan. Two times. And generally one of them is throughout the year, but in Ramadan is highly, highly desirable that you don't miss that time. One, قبيل الإفطار. Before you break your fasting. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ عِنْدَ كُلِّ فِتْرٍ عُتَقَاءَ مِنَ النَّارِ Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, right before you break your fasting, we'll be getting ready to break your fast, mashallah. And people really spend their time, you know, talking about the food, or how's that going to taste? Come on. The time before you do iftar, it is the time Allah will never neglect, ignore your prayer. So ask Allah forgiveness. Pray for the Muslims out there in the world who are suffering. Pray for your family. Pray for the entire Islamic world. Pray for your life in Akhirah. Pray for those who are dead who are Muslims. Yet in the graves, pray for them that Allah may forgive them. Ask Allah that Allah may cure your disease and the diseases of the people who are Muslims, especially. Use that time right before the breaking the fasting, right before iftar. And another timing is the time of a sahri, before morning prayer, the adhan for the fajr goes on. Ask Him for the life hereafter. Ask for Him for the blessings of the good knowledge, for the blessings of taqwa and piety and righteousness of Allah and consciousness of Allah. Ask Him lot many things out there related to your deen, to your faith, for the time you're going to meet your Lord. Pray, and everything you submit in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The time before the adhan for fajr goes on, and the time before the adhan for maghrib goes on, these two times we should never miss, inshallah. And finally, before the second last, we can have lot many Ramadans in a Ramadan. How is that? We fast the 30 days or 29 days of Ramadan, mashallah, we get 1 month of fasting. But if you help someone break his fast, man fattara sa'iman, if somebody who is fasting, invite them to break his fast with you and give him some foods, you will be getting the same reward as he has without diminishing anything from his rewards. He will get the reward of his fasting, and you'll be getting a copy of his rewards. Subhanallah. So if you invite 30 people every day, so you're going to get entire Ramadan, 30 fasting every day. So go for that. And if someone invites you for breaking the fast, if it's possible for you, accept the invitations so that your Muslim brother will get a chance to get the reward of a fasting. Subhanallah. And finally, as I mentioned in the beginning, try to add 83 years in your life. 83 years of your life. It's utilizing the night of Laylatul Qadr, the night of power. That's the night when Quran from Lawhul Mahfuz was sent down to the first sky. There is a house of Allah, namely Baytul Izzah. And that was happened during Ramadan. And it was in Ramadan, one of the mighty nights of Ramadan, that was Quran was given to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was meditating in the cave of Hira, in the Mount Jabal An-Nur, the Mount of Light. So Laylatul Qadr is a one night. You're talking about 8 to 9 hours. Utilize it. 5 days. The chance to win it out of five, not out of a million. You utilize 5 days. So do not, go after 27th of Ramadan. Mostly people believe 27th of Ramadan, that is only important day in Ramadan. It's true, but yet Laylatul Qadr, as mentioned by the majority of us scholars, is not only in 27th. It could be any odd nights after 20th of Ramadan. It could be 21 this year. It could be 23rd of Ramadan last year. It could be 29th next year or this year. will be going in different days. So people normally misunderstand. After 27th, they will disperse. Ramadan is over. No, there is one more night out there, 29th of Ramadan. It can be the night of Pops. So 5 nights. Don't be so lazy that you don't utilize it properly. 83 years. You do anything in this as if you did it continuously 83 years of your lifetime. So though we are 80 or 60 or 70 years old when we die, or even less or more, every year when we meet with Ramadan, we are adding 83 years into our lifetime. Subhanallah. So may Allah make it easy to do our Ramadan. And Ramadan, من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة في أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. If someone is not able to control his tongue, his mind, his eyes and his limbs from doing haram, Allah doesn't want any of thirst and hunger. What does it mean? If you're fasting and you do watch, subhanallah, what you've been watching before, and you waste your time without even opening an interpretation of Quran, or even reading Quran, or listening to some good talks, that you can be reminded of your life hereafter, that could make you understand above Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make substantial efforts to nourish your spirit, your soul during Ramadan. It's not like merely you abandon the food and drink. You also abstain from all the things that are not appreciated or desirable in the sight of the Sharia. So we ask Allah to help us. We do the proper Ramadan this year, inshallah. And start thinking about even tonight, because we are in the holy nights and days of Sha'aban, which is an amazing month, you know, which is preceding Ramadan. So I would recommend, inshallah, I would appeal to you, request to you that you may include me as well in all your prayers. And I will include you in my prayers, inshallah. So we will be meeting after Ramadan, inshallah, in these lessons, starting from 24th of August. So you may put down in your calendar, 24th of August, we will be beginning this Quran commentary, inshallah, going from the other surahs, you know, after Ramadan. Before I conclude, is there any questions out there you want to ask before we go for the prayer? Any questions? Anything you want to know about Ramadan? Any doubts? If you have, if you don't have, you know, take it easy. Doesn't matter. We'll just pray. Yeah. Okay, it's not necessarily you stay awake, but if you had a nap, you didn't literally sleep, intentionally sleep, but you fell asleep, doesn't matter. But to get the reward of Umrah, you should be awake doing dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You spend after Fajr doing dhikr, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, wa salat, sallallahu ala Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You be awake until the sun rises, and after the sun rises, wait until 20 minutes. If it's possible for you, if you're going for work and you have to be at your office at 7 o'clock, you know, or 6 o'clock, you can't make it. If that is the case, you know, you have a wish in your hand, in your heart. Have a wish in your heart, and Allah will reward for you, inshallah. So for that, you know, you should be awake, you know, praying. Any other questions? Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim alayhi. Allahumma ghafir lana ma qaddamna wa ma akharna wa ma asrarna wa ma asrafna wa atiqna ya rabbana min al-nar. اللهم عافنا من كل بلاء الدنيا ومصيباتها وفتنها وضيق عيشها وشرورها وعذاب الآخرة. اللهم بارك لنا فيما بقي من شعبان وبلغنا رمضان. اللهم سلم لنا رمضان وسلمنا إلى رمضان وسلم رمضان لنا وتسلمه منا متقبلا. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات والأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ربنا ارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. آمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. صلى الله تعالى وسلم على خير خلق سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.
سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين بحق صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته